Hey guys, this is Austin, and today we're taking a look at an incredible new gaming setup, the $35 Raspberry Pi 4. But of course, before we get into it, huge shout out to LG for sponsoring this video. This is the brand new LG UltraGear 27 GL850, which has the distinct honor of being the world's first nano IPS gaming monitor with a 1 millisecond response time. This is really the best of both worlds, as you're getting the high-end picture quality which is shared with their nano cell TVs, but you're also getting the super fast response time with a 144Hz refresh rate, HDR10, and it supports not only FreeSync, but also NVIDIA's G-Sync. And of course, to take advantage of the display, we are using a very high-end $3,500 computer from the Pro vs. Broke series. But that's not all you need for this guy. With a 1440p resolution and dedicated game modes for games such as first-person shooters as well as RTS, if you are in need of a monitor upgrade, definitely be sure to go check out the UltraGear at the link in the description. Now, while I might have a very high-end setup here, of course, today we're taking a look at something a little bit more on the budget end. So if you guys are not familiar with the Raspberry Pi, it is an incredibly versatile little computer. So not only are they dirt cheap, but they're also one of the easiest ways to get into learning how to not only work on computers, but especially when you get into the Linux side, it can be frustrating, but you also do a lot of cool stuff with it. So one of the cool parts about the Raspberry Pi 4 is that, well, it supports multiple displays. Now this year's Raspberry Pi 4 is actually a pretty significant upgrade. So for the same price as last year's model, you're getting a more powerful CPU, options for more RAM, as well as a ton of small but very nice improvements. So at that $35 price, we're finally getting USB 3.0, which is awesome. We're also getting gigabit Ethernet compared to 100 megabit internet from last year. We still have AC Wi-Fi, you have Bluetooth 5.0. I mean, this thing is properly spec'd. On top of all of that, we also now have a USB-C port. One of the really big upgrades here is on the CPU, the GPU, and the RAM. So on the processor side, we're going from an older A53, which are very small, weak cores, up to an ARM Cortex-A72. Now with a quad-core configuration, they claim that it's up to 3 times more powerful, which might be a slight exaggeration. But again, for a $35 computer, we're looking at a sort of level of performance which is not that far off of a lot of pretty decent smartphones. On top of that, the graphics have also seen a major upgrade. So not only does it now support 4K, but it actually supports a pair of 4K monitors at a full 60Hz. And on top of that, you can do things such as decode H.265 at 4K60. I mean, it's actually properly powerful. The cool thing is, even on such a low budget, you're still getting the full picture quality of these LG UltraGear displays. Now, is it powerful enough to say, run super powerful native games? No, because they don't exist for the Raspberry Pi. What it does allow you to do is make this thing not only just a little streaming box, but you can actually do some proper work on it. So with browsers such as Firefox and Chromium, this actually is a completely usable little desktop. Now one of the nice things about the Pi 4 is that in addition to the standard 1 gigabyte model, for $45 you can get 2 gigs of RAM, and for $55 you can get a full 4 gigs of RAM. Especially once you bump that up, it actually becomes pretty usable. In fact, this entire video, all the notes were written up inside Google Docs using the Raspberry Pi. Now it's not exactly fast, especially when it comes to things like YouTube playback, where it sometimes struggles to play a little bit of HD. However, generally speaking, this is a very usable little box, especially considering just how tiny it is. And of course, it is a Raspberry Pi. So you have all the same headers from last time, so you can customize it with cameras and all kinds of cool stuff. Because it's so small, it's really easy to build it into all kinds of enclosures, including things like emulation. I've seen actually a lot of these things go into like little like NES style boxes or even like a Game Boy. There's a ton of functionality for, again, a computer which costs $35. In fact, actually, some of the stuff that you have to kind of deal with here is very much meant for the older Pi. So things such as Windows, there actually is a Windows 10 version for Raspberry Pi, except it's for the 3, not the 4 yet. So unless you want to be Matt and hack it together, you're stuck with Raspbian. However, what is working is RetroPie. What is not working is it's on the wrong monitor. So the cool things about this is that with RetroPie, we have a huge variety of games which are playable. Now, previously we did a video on this, the Raspberry Pi Zero W, which at like $10 is one of the cheapest computers you can buy. However, the issue here is that it is, well, not fast, and a lot of games you actually can't run on this. However, with the added benefit of this newer processor, we should be able to play a fair few games. So let's try Automobili Lamborghini for the Nintendo 64, a classic that I'm sure you're gonna love. I'm gonna say that the performance is actually pretty solid, but I think that part of this is just the fact that this game is really twitchy. It's actually kind of fun though. This track's actually pretty cool. Oh, I'm gonna take the shortcut. Shortcut, 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 shortcut.
I love that about all the arcade games.
Yeah!
They all had a shortcut teaching you it's okay to cheat.
All right.
Excellent.
Yeah, audio is definitely not perfect here, but it's fine. Cause I'm in fourth, fifth, whatever this is. Man, do I just suck this much at N64 games? This is embarrassing. I'm in seventh right now. Oh, this is back when Mario Kart was actually hard. Ooh, oh no! 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 Get back here, Donkey Kong. Oh my God, what is wrong? How do I use the stupid? Excellent. So we can also emulate DS games. I'm gonna turn down the volume. Oh, Matt, am I starting from scratch?
Yeah.
Matt, no.
You need to figure out how to use the touch.
No, I know how to use a stylus.
Right there?
Sometimes, when I get into videos, I have what is called a little bit too much fun.
Shall we move on to something else?
Wait.
That's fine. I walked around. It was... Shut up, kid.
All you did was dance. You didn't test anything.
I walked around. It's Pokemon. What do you expect? It works. It's fine.
Spyro the Happy Dragon. Oh, I just blew fire. Oh. Although, I will say frame rate, not super smooth. But it is also a PS1 game. Some of these games did run at like 15 frames per second. So something else which is very useful to use the Raspberry Pi for is for Steam Link. So essentially, if you have another computer available, so right now we have a Windows PC down here, which is connected to this monitor, and the Raspberry Pi here. In theory, we can open up Steam Link, and it will just work, and we can play all the games we want on our $35 Raspberry Pi. Look at this excellent connection speed, 65, 70, woo. All right, we can get 80 megabits per second, which to be fair, right now the Raspberry Pi is over Ethernet and the gaming PC is over Wi-Fi, so sure, I'll take that. All right, we have our Xbox controller, fair connection, let's start playing. Okay, so right now, this monitor is running directly from our gaming PC, right? So this is as if we were not using Raspberry Pi or anything, we can natively go through here and it's all fine. On this display, this is the output from our Raspberry Pi. So essentially this should show you what the latency is. So, I mean, dude, that's like, that's pretty good. Like literally that's almost seamless. Let's try to play a game.
This is probably not the most ideal game.
No, this is actually a good example though. This is like the worst case scenario. Like if I can play CSGO successfully on a Raspberry Pi.
Well.
Dude, this is actually playable. Now mind you, I don't know if we're getting a full 60p feed to the Raspberry Pi. It's fine, I'm gonna get a kill, it's fine. I'm lining up the headshot, man. I can't get knifed.
That's my mouse. What the hell?
Okay. What can we deduce from this?
You destroyed my mouse.
Steam Link works fine.
You destroyed my mouse.
My skill level could use some work.